Good Thursday morning from the International Space Station Flight Control Room in Houston. This is Mission Control. You're looking at the room from the back of the room, a sweeping pan across the flight control team consoles as each member of this flight control team watches over systems aboard the International Space Station. The team today is once again led by Flight Director Royce Renfrew. See him seated there in the white shirt. He is overseeing this team throughout the morning and early afternoon. He's joined by Hal Getzelman once again, and Hal is serving as the voice link, the communications link between this team and the crew onboard the International Space Station. The International Space Station traveling 240 miles above the Southern Ocean as it heads toward the Tasmanian coastline from the southwest. The vantage point offers a sunrise and sunset every 45 minutes to the crew on board as the station circles the Earth every 1 hour and 32 minutes. And that is an orbital velocity, equates to an orbital velocity of about 17,000 miles per hour, or about 5 miles per second. The crew on board serving as Expedition 30 includes Commander Dan Burbank and two Russian colleagues that he arrived at the station with. Those are Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin. They now have been aboard the station for 122 days, and they've been in space now for 124 days. The other three crew members that joined them in this past December, late December, was Russian cosmonaut Oleg Kononenko, Andrei Kuipers, who you saw at the intro of the ISS update hour. He is from the Netherlands, and U.S. astronaut Don Pettit. They are in their 84th day aboard the station, 86 days for those three crew members in space. The first three are scheduled to come home at the end of April, and the other three are scheduled to come home in early July. Burbank's day consisted of measuring how astronauts interpret visual information in the microgravity environment of space as part of the scaling body-related actions in the absence of gravity experiment known as passages. He also prepped the station's high-rate communication system for some cable routing. Later, he will join the rest of his crew in a long-distance teleconference with the folks on the ground, focusing on program science, that to review all of the onboard science investigations. Pettit's day focused on lighting fires in space as part of the periodic investigations into how controlled flames behave in microgravity. That's known as the SLICE experiment. Results from these investigations hopefully will lead to improvements in technologies here on the ground that are aimed at reducing pollution emissions while also improving burning efficiency for a wide variety of industries. Kuipers divided his time today with maintenance work on the fluid physics experiment facility and also setting up equipment so that each crew member could weigh themselves, which is a periodic task throughout their stays on orbit. The Russian crew members continued work in the mini research module number one, known as Rosviet, the communication system in that module, and they also installed a stowage drawer as well. They're also performing routine housekeeping chores on the Russian segment of the station. Here on the ground, our European Space Agency partner is just getting underway with its launch readiness review for the next visiting vehicle to the International Space Station, ATV-3, the automated transfer vehicle known as the Eduardo Amaldi. If all goes well with the launch readiness review, it will be cleared for launch next Thursday, late at night, U.S. Central Time at 11:34 Central, 12:34 a.m. Friday, March 23rd. That would lead to a docking with the station about 6 days later in the early evening of Wednesday, March 28th, with a docking time of 5:34 p.m. Central Time. So that's all the activity that's going on orbit and here on the ground as the station is operating in excellent shape, circling the Earth every 92 minutes from this vantage point, traveling 17,000 miles per hour as a team of flight controllers watches over all of those systems in support of the Expedition 30 crew voyage aboard the International Space Station.